Saying I love you is not the words I want to hear from you. Not that I want to, not to say, but if you only knew how easy it would be to show me how.
Good evening, everyone. It's great to be here today. I welcome everyone that's here, family, friends, and loved ones. We are gathered together on this day to witness
and celebrate the marriage of Ricardo and Claudia.
We come together not to mark the start
of a relationship,
but to acknowledge and strengthen the bond that already exists.
The ceremony is a public affirmation of that bond.
And as their dearest family and friends, it is our honor and privilege to stand witness to this event.
This day is made possible not only because of your love for each other, Ricardo, Claudia,
but through the grace and support of your family and friends. It is our hope that your fulfillment and joy in each other will increase with each passing year. Marriage is a commitment, a lifetime commitment, where two people can find and bring out the very best in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relationship can equal, a physical and emotional joining that has the promise of a lifetime. And so at this time, I want to open up with prayer. So if we can bow our heads. Lord, we thank you for gathering everyone here today. We ask that you help Ricardo and Claudia to remember the strong love that they share, to work that love into practical things so that nothing can divide them. May their love always inspire them to be kind in their words, considerate of the other's feelings, and concerned for the other's needs and wishes. Increase their faith and trust in you. Bless their marriage with peace and happiness, and make their love fruitful for your glory and their joy, both here and in eternity. Amen. You may now be seated. Through the ages, many has tried to define love. Poems, songs, and books all have been written trying to describe this little four-letter word, love. But the best description I have found comes from God himself, since he is the author of love. And in his word, in the 1 Corinthians chapter 13, he describes the kind of love that must characterize your lives, Ricardo and Claudia, if you are to live in joy and harmony and honor with each other and also before God. But let's hear what that verse says in the Bible. It says, love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. While the commitment begins with the two of you, its effect radiates outward. It touches your family and friends and ultimately all of society. When this commitment is seriously made and continuously fulfilled, it leads to the richest and most rewarding of human relationships. Your relationship would take you more than love. It would take trust. To know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. Dedication to stay open to one another. To learn and grow, even when it is difficult to do so. And faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. While love is a natural state of being, these other qualities are not as easy to come by. They are not a destination, but a journey. Marriage is a give and take between two personalities, a mingling of two endowments, which diminishes neither, but enhances both.
Seeing that no moment is without meaning, Ricardo and Claudia, I ask you to take this marriage as a beginning of your lives together. Today signifies the creation of a new home and a new family for you both. May you be fulfilled by each other's love and friendship. May you be overjoyed by the promises you're about to make and the life you are about to create. Remember that in every marriage, Ricardo and Claudia, there are good times and bad, right? Times of joy and times of sorrow. Marriage is a journey, a time of adventure and excitement enhanced by the love, trust, dedication, and faith you share in one another. May the promises you make to one another today be led out to the end of your lives. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today is the day it all begins. Ricardo and Claudia, at this time, do you, with your family and friends, as your witnesses, present yourself willingly and of your own accord to be joined in marriage. Where you promise to care for each other in the joys and sorrows of life, come with me, and to share the responsibility for growth and enrichment of your life together. This is a moment, the best moment of the ceremony where we do a present your vows to each other. So, Ricardo, please repeat after me. I, Ricardo, take you,
Claudia,
to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
I give to you in the presence
of these witnesses,
my promise to stay by your side.
My promise to stay by your side.
In sickness and in health. In joy and in sorrow. As well as through the good times. And the bad. I promise to love you. Without reservation. Comfort you in times.
Of distress.
Encourage you to achieve. All of your goals. Laugh with you.
And cry with you.
Grow with you.
In mind and spirit.
Always be open and honest with you.
And cherish you for as long.
As we both shall live. Claudia, this is your time. Repeat after me, Claudia. I, Claudia.
Take you, Ricardo.
To be my wedded husband.
I give to you.
In the presence of these witnesses. My promise to stay by your side. In sickness and in health. She's making me cry. In joy and in sorrow. As well as through. The good times and the bad. I promise to love you. Without reservation. Comfort you in times of distress. Encourage you to achieve all of your goals. Laugh with you.
And cry with you.
Grow with you. In mind and spirit. Always be open and honest with you.
And cherish you.
For as long as we both shall live.
Beautiful.
At this time, we're going to do the exchanging of the rings. So I'm going to have the ring bearers. All right, thank you. This
is the moment and time where we exchange, where the bride and groom will exchange a room, but I do really want to say something before I do this.
Having this love in your hearts, you have chosen to seal your vows by exchanging rings.
From the earliest times, the circle has been a sign of completeness. The rings that you have chosen to wear have neither beginning nor end, much like your love for one another. They are a symbol of the words that you speak today. May these rings be from this day forward your most treasured adornment, and may the love they symbolize be your most precious possession. As you wear these rings, may they be constant reminders of these glad promises you are making today. May God will, can you take the ring? Place it on Connie's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring. As a symbol, of my love and faithfulness to you. And repeat after me.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. You can place another ring.
Ricardo and Claudio, from this moment forward, you will never be alone. You will carry with you the love of another person, giving you a completeness and renewed lightness. May your life together be immersed in love and excitement. May you strive to enrich each other in every possible way. And may you work to bring the peace you find to this world. At this time, having pledged their fidelity to one another, to love, honor, and cherish one another in the presence of this gathering, and by the authority vested in me by the Constitution and the laws of this state, it is my honor to now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to be the first to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Ricardo and Claudia Mejia.
Thank you.
Ricardo and Claudia invite you for the front doors of the mansion for champagne and hors d'oeuvres. So if you could just go up the stairs.